Good morning, everybody. Welcome. This morning, we're going to look at this topic called a subtopic, shorter distance between two points or locations. A short note here that the shortest distance between any two places on the Earth's surface is the route along the Great Circle. Okay, so we're going to explore that in this example. The question here is this: A and B are two points on the latitude 50 degree and their longitude are 30 degree west and 32 degree east respectively. We're asked to calculate the distance between AB measured along A, the parallel of latitude, B, the great circle. And we are told to take pi as this and arrow as this. Clear? So there you go. So the first thing we are going to do is to draw out. So solution, write that the coordinate given. The coordinate of A is 50 degree north and the longitude is 30 degree west. And B, the coordinate is 50 degree north and the longitude is 32 degree east, because from the question, it told us that A and B are two points on latitude 50. A and B are two points on the latitude 50, and their longitude is this. Good. So the next thing now is for us to draw the Earth. So do a finger sketch of the Earth. Indicate here what? Equator. Indicate your prime meridian also. But the next thing now is to use the coordinate to define our point. So the first one I'm going to do, let's draw the latitude. I told the latitude is 50 degree north. So this is it, 50 degree north. Then the longitude of A was 30 degree east west, 30, which is this. So there's a point of intersection here. So this is the point A. The same two for B, the latitude 50 is already there, and the longitude is 32, which is this. Draw a curvature down. So that's the point of intersection here. So if observe now, so this is the distance. If observe A and B is on a common latitude 50 degree, common latitude 50 degree. So that means that you're calculating distance on small circle. So the first thing we're going to do, since I'm calculating distance on a small circle, is to connect the point towards a point on the pole. So I'm going to connect, draw a line from A, this line here, to this point, let's say point X, then B2 to point X. Observe there's an angle here. This arc sustained, which I call this angle my, I call it beta. You can decide to call it A or any letter of your choice or any symbol of your choice. So that this angle, this arc sustained an angle, and I call it beta. Clear? And arrow here will be the radius of the parallel latitude. As you can see, that is arrow, small letter arrow. So what we're going to do now is for us to calculate the distance AB. I know the beta now will be what? Beta will be difference in what? Beta will be difference in the longitude. I observe one longitude is west, the other is east, and the rule is to add. So we're going to have 30 plus 32. That will give us 62 degree. Clear? So with this now, we can then go ahead to calculate the distance AB. Our other point is clear first. Good. So let me clear the screen. So if we look at it down here, so beta is this, 32. So the distance AB will be beta over 360 times 2 pi r. And arrow here is what is the radius of the parallel latitude. I remember that arrow here so let me write it out remember that arrow this arrow is 6400, that is arrow cos 4 alpha, and what is our alpha, which is the common world latitude, and the common latitude is 50. So we have it to be beta 62 over 360 times 2 times pi, which is 22 over 7 times 6, 400 times cos root 50. Good. So if we do that, we hit that out, we're having this value. So you put all of them simple way. So 62 times that and that and that, all over what? 360 times 7. That will give us this value here. Clear? So that means the distance AB is 4,453.396 kilometer. The next question, we're asked to calculate the distance along the grid cycle. What does that mean? So if you look at this diagram here, the distance along the grid cycle, watch between A and B. That distance is this arc. Sorry, this arc here. Because you can see that's what distance along what the grid cycle, and that is the distance. So for us to do that task, how do you achieve it? So that the major work here. So for us to do this, look at the procedures here. Let me just clear the screen, please. Okay. So the procedure is right here. So what I'm going to do is to draw what a straight line from A to the center of the earth, draw also a line from B to the center of the earth, something like this. Something like this. So you look at it right here. So you have something like this. So as a draw, first thing is to draw, connect A and B to the center of the earth, and join A and B by a straight line. So if you do that, this is what you're going to have. So a straight line, I'll join A to the center, join B to the center of the earth. So the arc here, look at this arc here, sustain an angle, and I call the angle theta. Now, if you know this angle theta, and go ahead to calculate what the distance, because this arc here will be theta, and that means this arc here, say A and B, that arc there is equals to theta over 360 times 2 pi r. But our task is that we don't know theta. That is the major work. So for us to calculate theta, we're going to use our trigonometric ratio to do that task. Good. So let's go ahead and do that. So for us to do that, observe carefully from this diagram. We discover that this line, the prime meridian, bisect the straight line with the blue line, bisect it at what, 90 degrees. So that means that if we bisect it at 90 degrees, that means this angle here, A, X, M, let me call your M. So this midpoint here, so that's a midpoint here, let me call your M. So this line here, you can see this line, bisect this angle here, beta. So you are going to have, you have something like a right angle triangle. So you have line, this triangle, A, M, X. So this line here bisects what? Beta, and also bisects what? Theta. I remember beta is what? 62. So half of 62, 31. I mean, yes, 31. Yes, also 31. Clear? So look at a shape like this. Look at this shape here. You have something like this. Clear? So you can see that line bisects the beta, 31, 31. And also bisect theta. Theta over 2, theta over 2. Good. Let me clear this screen, please. Good. So So our task now is for us to calculate this angle here, theta, this angle here. Theta. For us to do that, we are going to use our trigonometric ratio. If you observe carefully, this angle here is given to us 31. So if you know this distance here, say AM or MB, then we can pull out this other triangle and calculate theta. Clear? So for us to do that, let's pull out this other first angle here. So if we do that, so you'll be having something like this. So as I say, let's consider this angle, this triangle, this right angle triangle AMX. So if we do that, so you're going to have something like this. So considering right angle triangle AMX, which is this. Okay. So what we're going to do, our sine 31 is what opposite all of what hypotenuse, and the opposite is AM, and the hypotenuse is what R. So you're having sine 31 equals to AM over R. So make AM the same in the formula. AM will be equals to what R times sine 31. And remember, R is what capital letter R times cos what? Cos alpha, and alpha is the common latitude. What that means is arrow is the radius of the earth times cos alpha. And remember, alpha is what the common latitude, which is 50. From the question, so you're going to have it to be AM to be equals to R times cos 50 times sine what 31. So let's say this equation one, you want to go further to write the sentence as this two. Good. So the next thing, remember our interest is to get this angle here. So the next thing is to consider this other triangle, this other right angle triangle, say AMO or OMA. So if you consider that triangle, say considering the right angle triangle AMO, so you'll be having this right angle triangle here. So let me put something here that's missing. Remember, this angle here is theta over what? Theta over 2. Okay, good. So let's calculate this angle now. We know this place now, AM, to be R times cos 50 times sine 31. So look at it right there. So sine theta over 2 will be opposite, which is AM, all over what hypotenuse, which is capital R. So if you have that, AM is what is this? This value here. AM is this. So if you do that, you're having this value over R. So R will cancel out R. Clear? And you'll be left with so let me clear the screen, please. So you'll be left with sine theta over 2 equals to cos 50 times sine 31. Clear? So solve for theta over 2, take the sine inverse. If you hit this out, you have this 0.3311. So taking the sine inverse, you're having theta over 2 equals to sine inverse of 0. This. So the sine inverse of this is 19.33556. So what do you do? Solve for theta now. So just cross multiply. So theta will be 2 times this. We should have this. So now we'll know this. With this now, we'll know theta now. That is, we'll have theta now. This angle now. We know it now. So that the angle sustained by this arc. So that the angle sustained by the arc. So if you know that now, we can go ahead to do what? Calculate the distance of the arc. So the distance along the gray circle will be theta times 2 times pi r over 360. And our theta is 38.67. So if you hit everything out, you have this value here. So that means that the distance along the gray circle is this. Now let's compare something else. Let's look at this value along the gray circle and we calculated the value along the small circle. Now, this is what the distance along what the gray circle, 4,321, that and that. Now, the distance along the small circle, What was the value? The value was 4,453 points, which is smaller. You discover that the distance on the great circle is smaller compared to what that. So in the conclusion, we can say that conclusion from the above calculation, distance calculated along the great circle gives the shortest route comparatively to the value obtained when computing along the parallel of latitude. Clear? So you can see, so the conclusion in nutshell is the distance calculated, the shortest distance between 2 points is the distance calculated along the great circle. Clear? So if you have any question, feel free to chat me up. Thank you. Have a great day. Bye for now.